You said you felt so happy you could die. I told myself that you were right for me, but felt so lonely in your company. But that will love her to make us still remember.
Waiting for a few people to jump on so I can get my tarot cards ready. Nobody on there? Alright, now try changing glasses to a nicer pair. I have to clean them, I think. Hey, can you guys hear me alright? I'm not sure. I've got my phone standing up on, I think, where the speaker is. I just wanted to check the volume. Can you hear me all right? And is that music just sort of looking like background music? That's what I was aiming for. Oh, that's better. I can see. Good. Hello, Rachel. Can you just tell me how the volume is here? My voice and the music? Oh, you can hear me. Good. Thank you. Oh. Donkey in my swamp, Disneyland. Hello, everybody. Looking forward to some lovely messages from Spirit tonight. I'm all tuned in. I've done my little attunements. I'm just going to get my cards ready here. I'm using two decks today. Akashic Tarot. That one. And my messages from the guides, oracle cards, the James Van Praagh deck. I love both of these decks. So I'm going to get them ready by clearing them out. So I'm going to start with this deck, my oracle cards. Let's see what comes up. There's a few people on there. So I'm assuming you guys are here because you're hoping to get a message. And I've just got some, I've put a playlist on YouTube in the background, which is, I typed in Aussie rock. So it could be random. I don't know what's gonna come up there. Okay, this deck's ready to go. Would we need to gift for reading? No, I don't do this for money. I do this just because I feel called to and I enjoy it. So there's no requirements to give me any money, any gifts, nothing like that. It's just for fun. If you want a significant reading, this is just literally just channeling messages from Spirit on here and whatever cards come up. But if you want a proper soul realignment reading, then you can go and get a private reading by going onto my website, and that's a paid reading. This is just for fun. So Hello from Pensacola, Florida. What time of the day is it there? I think it's yesterday, is it? Now, guys, if you ask me a question and I don't respond, that just means I haven't seen it. I've been concentrating or looking at my cards, so keep asking it until I see it, and I'll acknowledge all your questions, okay? Oh, there's one. So, who is this for? I've got the treasure here. Now, this means to me a love life reading, Rochelle. Hold on, yes. This treasure card is about somebody looking for treasure, looking for something that's important to you that you're having trouble finding and probably feeling hang on. Sorry, I just had to decline a live request. And the music's actually distracting me too, so I'm going to turn that off as well. Sorry. So somebody's been looking for something and something that's really important and having trouble finding what it is that you're looking for. But it's actually there. It's there. You just have to be patient. This fellow here, it looks like he feels like he's been robbed. Someone's stolen all of his precious things. But there's a treasure box right at the back there. All he has to do is lift the lid and see it. So it might be something that's kind of in your face. It's in your face. It's around somewhere. It's close by and you're not looking in the right direction. So turn around. Try looking somewhere different. Try a different approach. Okay, love life reading for Rochelle. I am going to use oracle cards for that one. You have a crazy life, so it's not you. Okay. Can I have a message for Rochelle, please? My TikTok follower, Rochelle, around her love life. There we go. Oh. Understand your body is what it says. Now, this means to me there's some signs and symptoms there that you need to be listening to. It might actually be your intuition. If your heart's telling you something, then whatever it is, you need to listen to that. If you get a gut feeling, listen to that. That's the message that I'm getting for you around your love life. Hello there, Vintage Nurse Matthew, Melbourne or the Bulldogs tomorrow? I don't know. And I think I've had you on my readings before, Matthew, and you know that I don't do predictions because I can predict something now and anything could happen that could change that. Hello, Bree Jackson 680. So I'm not going to predict who's going to win the grand final. Chelsea Bunn. Can I have a love life reading, please? Name is Chelsea. Hi, Chelsea. Yeah, Rochelle, did that resonate with you? Because it's kind of an odd card to get. Your question was around your love life and the message was understand your body. So I'm interpreting that to mean that there's some sort of something physical that you need to be listening to there that will give you the answer. I hope that makes sense to you. Let me come back here. Chelsea, another love life reading. Okay, I'm going to use the same deck again. This is my oracle deck. It's messages from the spirit guides, this one. Chelsea, are you in touch with your spirit guides? Can I have a message with Chelsea, please? Chelsea, around her love. Oh, gut-wrenching, Rochelle. Yeah, okay, yeah. Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that for you. Okay, there we go. This is for Chelsea. Chelsea, follow the golden rule. So the golden rule is about treating others how you want to be treated. It's around what you put out there will come back to you. So I'm not sure what your situation is. If you're looking for love, then put love out there and love will come back to you. If you have love and you're not sure whether it's right to you, then treat that person the way you want to be treated. If you don't get that feeling back, then it's definitely not right. I hope that makes sense to you. Just going to click here on these new messages. Oh, thanks for the rose, Matthew. That's lovely. Matthew, did you have a question? You are Chelsea. That's good. Hang on. Mary, can you read something on a loved one? Do you mean... Oh, it makes sense, Chelsea. That's good. Mary, can I read something on a loved one? I sometimes can. I guess it depends on what context you're asking me. Can you ask me exactly what it is, what your question is, and also I'll see what I can come up with that way. Oftentimes, guys, I don't know really what your question is or what it is that you need. I just ask my guides to give me what you're asking for. So if you're concentrating on something and my guides can connect in with your guides, you know, my people speak to your people, they do lunch, then that's how the message comes through. And to me, I can read a card and think, oh, what the fuck does that mean? It doesn't really answer the question, but then to the other person who's receiving it, it will make sense. So asking about house, is that a good question? Yeah, okay, Matthew, I think that is a good question, and I'm drawn to this deck for that one. So I will give you a card for that one. Okay, Mary, thank you. Yes, I'll come back to that in a second. I'll do this card for Matt and then I'll come back to that one. Matt, that jumped out. Set your intention, okay? Set your intention, Matthew. So if you're trying to find a new home, I like intentions to kind of be called manifestations. Some people call them prayers, as in if you're old-fashioned religious, you might be saying a prayer to God or whoever it is you pray to. But every day, set your intention, probably every morning and every night. Say, I have a fabulous new home. I am living in a fabulous new home, and set intentions that way every single day. Set your intention about what it is that you want. Tell the universe what it is you're asking for. Hello, Perth! Tell the universe every day what it is that you're asking for, and continue to set your intentions. It's kind of like the opposite of crawling into a shell and crying about poor me, poor me. I hope that makes sense. Now, Mary... Mary, I'm going to use, you know what I'm going to use? I'm going to use my pendulum and douse to talk to your son for you. Mary 8891E. Can I please connect with Mary 8891E? Have I got Mary there? Okay, Mary's question is around if her son is at peace. Is there anything we can say to Mary about her son? Son at peace. Okay, I'm getting yes, your son is at peace there. Now I'm going to get a card. This is still for Mary. That was a yes, so I'll see if I can get something a little bit more specific now, Mary. I don't know what this is going to be, but hopefully it's make something that will make sense specifically to you. Card for Mary regarding her son. Wishes fulfilled. So this is a life of abundance. This is a place where there's everything you could possibly want. It's got food, it's got jewels, gems, it's got books and entertainment. It's got a beautiful view out there of a natural lovely scene. So Mary, what this is saying to me is abundance, happiness, joy, everything you could possibly want. I hope that's comforting for you. Okay, GM Freak. Sorry, I'm just going to scroll back up, guys, and see what messages I missed there. I don't chase, I attract. What belongs to me simply finds me. Oh, that's a manifestation that I've heard around TikTok a lot. Thank you, GM Freak, for that. Yeah, I think that's specifically for you, Nurse Matthew. I don't chase, I attract. What belongs to me simply finds me. There are many, many affirmations that you could say. Many, many affirmations that you could say. I certainly don't want to be prescriptive. That's a great example. But for you, you can say it however feels comfortable for you. A lot of people who work on manifestation techniques talk about saying things as if it's in the present tense, as in you already have it. I don't know if that makes a difference or not. I certainly like to ask for what I want, and I certainly like to tell the universe to show me
how to get what it is I want. So I don't just say something like, I want to make $1,000 this week. I'll say, show me the way that I can find more customers, or show me an opportunity to create some more money. And then that happens for me. Probably not quite so simple as that. There are some other things that you have to do, but setting intentions are really, really important. Mary, where am I from? I'm from Australia. I'm in Victoria, in central Victoria at the moment, but in my life I've lived in Melbourne, in the capital city here in Victoria, and in lots of different places around Victoria, central Victoria mostly. Just scrolling down now. So you're saying call the agent every day, Matthew. Well, that's between you and the agent, but you need to set your intention to the universe. Tell the universe what you want, not the agent. Does that make sense? Yeah, GM Freak, absolutely. Ask a question. Can you heal your own body? Now, yeah, I really strongly believe that there are ways that you can heal your own body. And one of the really good ways, I think, I've been doing some work in this area myself, and it's just fascinating. One of the ways that I think is a good place to start, if you haven't made a start on this, is to get onto YouTube or Gaia, if you're subscribed to Gaia TV, and type in guided meditation. Guided meditation for healing, something like that. So it'll take you into a place where if you can really connect and get into those alpha waves and concentrate on the breathing and then fall asleep to it, which is what I like to do. I think it's the best way to fall asleep. The affirmations will work on your subconscious whilst you're sleeping, and your subconscious can or has the power to heal your body at a cellular level, all sorts of things that your body can do for you. So if you haven't done that before, that's a really great place to start. Guided meditations, GM Freak. Oh, Mary, I'm glad to hear something makes you feel better. That was, what do I mean being my manifest? Well, to manifest something is to create what you want, is to draw or attract to you exactly what it is that you want. And I believe that we're here to experience ourselves in this incarnation. And in order to experience ourselves to our fullest potential, we should be manifesting the life of our dreams, right? So that's what I'm working on, and I'm doing it. I'm loving my life right now since I had my spiritual transformation, and I've learned so much about how to manifest things. Just abundance and joy and happiness every day. Oh Lord, that's where the crazy spiders are. Yeah, there are crazy spiders here. There are all sorts of crazy things here. Rach, hi. Will I meet someone else soon? Yeah, let's have a look. So that's a yes no question, which are always the easiest for me to get via my pendulum. So Rochelle wants to know if she will meet someone again soon. Will Rochelle meet someone again soon? Yeah, I'm seeing that as a yes. I don't think your next partner is going to be your soulmate, though. Sorry, Rochelle. I think you've got to kiss a couple more toads before you find your prince. Or princess, in your case, if that's... Yeah, I'm getting a no. Okay, I'm getting that it's a prince. Yeah, and I'm getting that your soulmate is there, but... the soulmate is there, but it's not your next relationship. So... I don't know if that's a happy news or sad news. Oh, hello, Delta Wilmot. How are you, baby girl? Matthew, at the moment, the universe is the agent, as the market is very tough. Okay, well, I'm here to tell you that the universe is not a real estate agent. The universe is bigger and more important than a real estate agent. So if you are setting your intentions to a real estate agent rather than the universe, I don't think that's going to work. What's my religion, Mary? I would probably, if I had to classify myself these days, I'd probably classify myself as New Age or spiritualist. I was raised Catholic, Roman Catholic. but I rejected that religion a long time ago, and I became quite anti-religion, very, you know, even didn't even believe in God. I rejected everything about religion, and it's only in the last, you know, couple of years that I've really started to learn, and because I can channel directly from spirit now, so I have a lot more information about the spirit world, and that includes our source, the source of all creation, which of course most people call God. So I'm no longer an atheist, but I'm not religious. I don't subscribe to any organized religion. Basically, I kind of do my own thing and believe my own beliefs, if that makes sense. Assumed wasn't sure if it was correct. Thank you, Christine. You're welcome. Nice. My wife is Catholic and I'm Wiccan, so open-minded. Yeah, good. So, yeah, I mean, I suppose Catholicism is a religion. Wiccan could be considered a religion, and I probably subscribe to Chrissyism, if anything. jokes, Joyce, I understand what you mean. I will take your advice. Yeah, well, vintage Nurse Matthew, I think that, you know, I mean, if it's something that you want, you have the right. We all have the right to get what we want, no matter what it is. There's nothing dirty about being wealthy, or nothing, you know, obscene about wanting what you want. So set your intentions, tell the universe what you want. And when I say the universe, I mean, the universe is not a person sort of out there saying, should we let him have it? Yes. Or should we not? No, it doesn't work that way. The universe, it's a stupid term for a collective consciousness, I suppose. But I don't know how else to put it. That's why I use that term. So, yeah, I think you should just definitely be putting it out there. I guess what I'm saying is, if you don't ask, you don't get, right? So at the very least, there's obviously actions that you need to take to get what you want, but at the very least, you need to make it clear and put it out there what it is that you want. Yeah, now I'm going to do another quick general reading because I'm feeling a question. There we go. What made me decide to read cards? Okay. It is a good question for me. I don't think it wasn't actually a decision. It just kind of happened. I fell into it. I think reading cards is only a really small part of what I do. My main work is what I call soul realignment. And I do that as paid readings, as privates, you know, one-on-one readings, which you can find on my website if you want to. This stuff, the cards, is really only a bit of an aside for me. It's a tool to help me to connect with spirit. I don't consider myself a tarot carder, that I do it for a living. I consider it, you know, a bit of a side hustle, really, that's just for fun. Yeah. Oh, yeah, Mary, I'm glad you're here. Ask as many questions as you want. And it kind of makes me think, too, like that question, you know, what made me decide to read cards? Well, I don't think I really decided. In fact, there's so much of late since I've been involved in this spiritual world, so much stuff that I would not say is decisions at all. It just happens to me. It's more like a symptom of being in connection, if that makes sense. Yeah, it's weird, but I feel more led now and driven to do the things that I do. And I'll do, you know, when something comes into your head and you feel like it's an imagination or it's made up or whatever. Now, I completely go with it. If something comes into my head and I get an idea, I think, oh, that's what I'm going to do. I have to do that. And acting upon my ideas or thoughts or intuition or gut feelings is what has gotten me to this marvelous life that I have now, where I'm so fucking happy. So yeah, I've learned to really trust that and go with it. And tarot cards is just one of those things. What pushed me into the spiritual world? Well, I think that really would have been COVID and lockdown, just sort of going within, yeah, not being so focused on the external world and my external world and everything around me and having to do this and having to do that, being at home, being sort of more introspective, I suppose. And at some point I again fell into it. It just kind of just happened for me rather than me deciding to chase after it, if that makes sense. You read, Mary, what do you read?
Knowing someone's story. Now, thanks, Mary. Sorry, I got a bit distracted there because there's someone on here who just said, what makes one decide to stop brushing their hair? That's really hurtful and a fucking horrible person to say things like that. I'm turning off invites on here. Piss off, you. I'm gonna, like, block that person. How do you do that? Block. Right. Now, I think I need a moderator. Bree Jackson, do you want to moderate for me?
Tractor, I've got your message, your question there. I'm going to come back to you in a second. I just want to... So I'm quite new to this side of things, guys. I've only done live a couple of times on here. Yeah, thank you, Vintage Nurse. I have just blocked that person. I figured it out. Thanks, guys. But I want a moderator. So how do I do that? Ask someone to moderate something. I'm just pressing the buttons that I see on here. I'm looking for a button. Okay. Oh, thanks, Bree Jackson. Yes, click name and manage. I'm doing amazing. Thanks, Mary. I like people like you who are very uplifting and supportive, right? Because it costs you nothing to be kind. Kindness is free. Why on earth would you not be kind? And if you choose to not be kind, just shut your mouth. Like, don't say anything. Why would you say something hurtful to people for no reason and with no provocation? That I don't understand. I'm naive, a bit dumb in that way, but why? It's the why that I don't understand. So let me just talk to this now. I want to manage you, Bree. Add moderator. Right, so Bree, you're now a moderator for this live. So I believe what that means, someone's made me moderators before for their live, so I know what that means. It means that if somebody can, if somebody sends nasty messages or anything like that, you can just block them for me. So if you could keep an eye on my chat for me in case I miss things, that'd be really good just while you're here. I'm not saying you have to stay for the whole thing or anything. Yeah. Now, I had a message question. Tractor 759 wants to know, will they meet someone new? Let's have a look. That's a yes or no question. So really easy to answer with my pendulum. Tractor. Is Tractor going to meet someone new? It's a great big yes. It's always, I think, you know, it's a really broad question. Tell me who you're looking for, Tractor. Are you looking for the love of your life? Are you looking to meet new friends? Are you looking for your soulmate? Okay, I'm seeing. Is Tractor going to meet? I think I just answered my own question, Tractor. Your soulmate is... Actually, you already know your soulmate. You've met them before. Okay, so, yeah, I'm saying that the next person, your next significant other, is someone that you've already met, somebody that's already in your life. The craziest thing I've done... Skydiving. Well, I don't know if skydiving's even considered to be crazy these days, is it? I think it's quite mainstream. Geez, I've done some crazy, crazy shit in my life. Before I started on this journey, I used to drink a lot of alcohol, a lot. I used to smoke a lot of cigarettes. I used to smoke dope. When I'd get pissed, I think I did some really stupid, stupid shit. Lots and lots of stuff. I have no idea what I would consider to be the craziest. What's the craziest thing I've ever done? Oh, I don't know. I suppose maybe just packing up my stuff on a whim and deciding that's it, I'm quitting my job. Good job. Jobs that I've studied all my life for and very well paid and very secure and well respected within my career, and gone,
fuck it, I'm going to run my own business, pack up all my stuff, leave, and, yeah, change my life around as I know it. That was pretty crazy for me. What questions did I miss? Did I miss any questions there, anyone? If I've missed any questions that you want messages for, just rewrite them in there. Yeah, so Mary, did that answer your question? Just literally just leaving everything behind in my life. I bought a camper van and decided to travel around Australia, which I still am planning to do. I've had one little mini trip up to the border, but that's as far as we can go at the moment here because we're in kind of, we're not in lockdown per se here in central Victoria, but all the borders are closed and we can't travel yet. Poor Bali. Yeah, I've done some pretty crazy things in Bali, I suppose, but what happens in Bali stays in Bali, right? Not for TikTok. Questions, guys? You ran away. Yeah. Yeah. All right, this is going to be general, whoever this is for. No, don't know who it's for. General. Oh, there we go. Oh, God. I wonder why they get these cards all the time. Okay, the Queen of Roses. She's beautiful. Can you see her there? She's really, she's about love. And my number one spirit guide, Bob, gives me the shits when he gives me cards about love. Because if I ask for a card about myself, you know, it's generally he's sending me something about love. But I'm not looking for love. I'm not interested in love. I'm not interested. I don't want to meet anybody. I just want to be single. I'm happy on my own, and that's the way I want it to stay. So I'm hoping this card is not for me. The Queen of Roses, she's about someone in your life or coming into your life who is really sweet and loving and has a lot to offer you in the way of heart and community and relationship. It doesn't necessarily mean it's your partner relationship, your loving relationship, but it's just a woman who represents love in your life. I think the message here is just to pay attention to her. Yeah, be nice to her. Because she's helpful. She's on your side. I remind me of someone been through a lot. I usually am not nosy, but I love hearing. Yeah, I don't mind if you're nosy. I suppose that's what social media is all about, right? Getting to know other people. remind me of someone so strong, been through a lot. Well, I think you could probably say that about most people. I don't really know anyone who I wouldn't describe as having been through a lot. When you think about it, oh, is that your mum tractor? That's good, good. You have two women say you're good as well. Yeah, but I think, and the work I do with soul realignment, when I'm looking at people's soul blueprints, most of the energetic patterns and karma that happens in people's life, kind of like those karmic patterns and the things that just kind of, you know, feel like they're stuck to you, have come from past lives, and they've come from 200 years ago, 300 years ago, 400 years ago. And I find this with people over and over and over again. So all the stuff that's happened in your life is significant. Mary, your wife hasn't been through a lot? Oh, yeah, maybe that's why that thought just came into my head about past lives. They potentially have been through. She potentially has been through a fair bit in previous lives or previous incarnations, and maybe done some really good hard work at a soul level to make sure that now she's, you know, she's got this opportunity to experience herself in the best way that life can offer. And that's a really beautiful thing. The skin question, my skin is looking good. What's the secret? Oh, it's probably, there's a filter on here. I pressed the button that said effects, and then it said, hang on, let me have a look at what it's called. Effects. And it's called bling. So when you see little things shining, yeah, see that? Oh, it's shining off my beads. That's the bling filter, that's why. Although some people do tell me when I do this sort of stuff or readings online that they can see orbs around my head. And I did a Zoom meeting the other night where I could see them a lot, orbs, little tiny white balls of light flying around my head. She's spoiled and you're her first relationship and she's 56. Spoiled. That's cute. We use that term too about people being spoiled. Spoiled is I'm seeing deserving, you know, it's a well-deserved spoiledness. That's how I'm seeing it. General reading for Tractor 759. Yep, sure. Clean these out. Okay, I'm doing my Akashic Record Tarot here. It's for you, Tractor. And we'll see what comes out. Bob, can I have a message for this follower, please? Tractor 759. Take your time, Bob, won't you? Take your time. Take your time. Message for Tractor 759. There we go. Oh, the karmic trench, Tractor. So what this is saying, I'll just show you the picture first and see what you get from that. Can you see this person? It's a farmer. Now, it means that you're in a karmic trench that you don't need to be. It means that you've dug all of these trenches, right? So you've sowed these rows. You've dug and dug and dug, and there's plenty there, plenty there. All you have to do now is get out. You don't need to stay in this karmic trench anymore. I think what I'm hearing for you is change something, do something a little bit different. Whatever pattern that you're in, you're stuck in that, and it's almost like because it's a pattern, it's become a habit for you, and you're just going to keep going on that same way unless you change something. So my suggestion to you is do something different. I don't know what it is. It could be related to work, it could be related to living circumstances, it could be related to friendships, could be related to money, something in your life that you're doing that you just feel like you're in a pattern and you're stuck in a trench. Change it up. You have the right to change it up, and you're free. There's nothing keeping you in that karmic trench except you. So, you know, any patterns there that you think are not serving you anymore, change them. Your wife thinks she's well deserving. Well, she's probably right. It's just a feeling that I'm getting. I don't know who it is, but I'm getting that feeling when you say those messages. You need that card too. Well, the advice is good for everyone, Mary, and the fact that you're here means you're probably meant to hear it. So if there's something in your life that's feeling a bit patternish and you're feeling a bit stuck in a trench, just do something different. Generally, that's all we need to do. And often you can flip something different like that with a change of mindset in any way it is. And did you say you're a Wiccan? You might need to maybe, if you believe in the power of spells, you might need to do some sort of a change it up type of spell, something to flip a negative into a positive or something like that. Makes sense for you, Tractor. I'm glad. Yeah, and I hope you've got something in mind that you can change that's reasonably painless for you. with changing things up, it doesn't need to be a massive change like me. You know, I literally did quit my job, leave my house, just, you know, buy a van. That's massive change, but that's me. I'm a pretty extreme sort of a person, and I'm really learning to take my messages literally. You can do things on a lot more subtle level than that. Yeah. I'm changing it up now. I'm going back to this other deck, using my James Van Praagh. Still stuck on this toxic one. Toxic one what? What did I miss? Toxic what, Mary? I'm making a mess of these. Oh, toxic. Oh, mistress. Okay. Hi, Aussie Golden Girl. I'm not sure if you were trying to jump on live. I turned off the guest thingy because I had a few people and requesting, and I was just kind of in the middle of doing messages for people. But I'm really, really happy if you do want to jump on. I don't know how that works now that I've turned it off. Maybe I can turn it back on again. Anyway, Aussie, Aggie, are you looking for... Okay, Aggie, are you looking for a message? If you give me a question, I can answer it for you, I hope. We'll see what pops out. No questions for you. You put the prettiest things, your flowers and love hearts and things like that, and I've seen some of those in your messages as well. I am only just learning how to do a smiley emoji. To me, all the little faces look the same. They all just look like a happy face, and that's probably as far as I go. Simple girl. Oh, yeah, what's your request, Al? Oh, you're saying you got one. Yeah. It's a bit slow, isn't it, this live thing? When you're talking, it kind of, I don't know if maybe it's on a delay or something. Oh, thank you for the roses, Vintage Nurse. Oh, thanks for the likes, Mary. Ah, Aggie, you know how to do it. Do you know what I reckon they need in the emoji world? They need more Aussie symbols. I know that there's, you know, the Aussie flag and there's a kangaroo and stuff like that, but I can see your beautiful flowers there. Is there any wattle? So that's a challenge for you now. See if you can find a wattle emoji. All right, this is going to be a general message. I'm not sure who this is for, but I can feel it coming. Oh, thanks, Mary. You're lovely too. Come on, Bob. What's a message for the people who are watching? What's a message for the people who are watching? What have we got? Message for the people who are watching. Okay, there it is. Ah, I got two of them. Stay open-minded is one of them. Something coming for you. Okay. Stay open-minded. So this is for somebody who is maybe feeling a bit closed in their thought processes. It just is telling you to think outside the square. This one is saying you are here for a reason. So if somebody out there, one of you who is watching, is feeling a bit blah, feeling like you've got no directions or no goals, or you're having trouble meeting your own goals, just know that you're here for a reason and those goals will come to you. Now, Aggie, I'm going to switch decks for you. Something coming for you. So message for Australian Golden Girl, please. Aussie Golden Girl. Message for Aussie Golden Girl. She wants to know what's coming for her. She wants to know what's coming. What's coming for Aussie Golden Girl? Aha, the willow. This is strength. So this tree is all about how strong you are. Apart from being amazingly beautiful and natural, it's a tree that is not just looking beautiful on the outside, but its roots go really, really deep, and its roots are able to draw all of that water, all of this. See all that? This tree's got an aura. It's drawing the birds to it. Absolutely natural beauty and natural energy. So what it's telling me for you, Aggie, is strength. There is strength there in abundance for you. If you need it, if you're having a difficult time, or if there is a difficult time coming up for you that you're worried about, just know that your inner strength is there. Your inner strength and beauty as well. It's like people are attracted to this Eunice, you know, this willow tree of you. They don't see the roots that go really down deep into the earth. That all they see is the beautifulness and the aura from the outside. But that strength that you've got is inner, and it's so innate and it's in you. You'll never lose it. So really, if you've got that, you don't have to worry about anything, do you? There's nothing in this world that can damage you because you're stronger than all that shit. Yeah. say, right at the top on the left-hand side of my thing, it says relationships. Does anybody know why it says that there? Oh, I see your lovely flowers there, darling, but I don't see any wattle. Sorry, I'm just taking the piss. I don't think any of those flowers are Australian. Oh, you're welcome, Aggie. I'm changing decks. Yes, I'm definitely changing decks. I'm changing decks. Ah, death is an illusion. So for any of you who are struggling with the idea that we are an immortal soul, yes, I didn't think you... Can you get onto TikTok about that, please, Aggie? It's, yeah, it's not good enough. So death being an illusion, and I'm not sure if you're still here, Mary, or somebody else who's lost a child or lost someone in their life, just know that they don't feel dead. They don't feel like... The only thing that they feel is changed is that they don't have a physical body, and so it's bloody hard to communicate with us. They still try all the time. It's us that can't hear it, and that's because we've got a brain, a human brain. It kind of... Good, thanks, Aggie. Yeah, our human brain is what stops us from being able to hear and listen to those messages and those communications. And it does that for a reason. It's our ego. It's supposed to be there to stop us from making stupid mistakes. It gives us warnings and things like that, and it protects us from everything that's that could be potentially harmful to us. But it just protects us way too much. It also wants us to concentrate and focus on this human life and focus on our self-expression in this human life, in this incarnation, and in this embodiment. But whilst it's doing that, it's actually stopping us from having those communications. And so, you know, learning to be able to communicate with spirit is like learning a whole new language and it can be tough. I'm still learning. I'm certainly just scratching the surface of the things that I... Oh, did you guys hear that? I think we might be having another, what do you call it? Earthquake here. No, I'm kidding. Unless anybody else felt anything. Did you feel anything? Oh, God, I've got to see what that was now. Oh, you have the same Audi. Right, so the only reason I bought this, I'm not particularly a light blue fan, but I bought this one because it had the koalas on it and it was the only really Aussie-themed thing I could find. I really wanted a purple one, but there's no... purple ones with the pictures on or the themes that I like. But I think I'm going to buy another one anyway because I need to have one that I wear and one that I wash. I had to wash this one after I came back from our camping trip because it had all sorts of camping goodness all over it. And I really missed having an hoodie to wear in that day. It took a full 24 hours to dry. So I'm going to have to buy a second one. Any recommendations for a nice hoodie? What's your favourite hoodie? I'm happy to look at those. I would potentially like to have every hoodie, but storage space is a problem. So, yeah. All right, I'm doing another general card now for whoever needs this message. Hello to any newbies on there that I haven't said hello to yet. And just a reminder, guys, if you send me a question on there and I'm looking at the cards or daydreaming or whatever's going on and I miss your question, please ask it again, okay? I'm not ignoring you. I will acknowledge every question. But I just get a bit distracted sometimes, which is par for the course with what I'm doing. So, card for these guys on TikTok, please. What's a message for these guys who are watching now? Have you got a general message for me, please? General message. Lightning bolt. I'll come back to you, Kylie Emma 1990. Lightning bolt. So somebody on here is going to get hit with some news very soon, and it's going to be a shock out of the blue. I always like to think of this card as being a really positive one, because for me a lightning bolt is like a light bulb moment. It's like a, oh, duh. Yeah, I got it. a message that, you know, you really kind of were expecting, but yeah. So I don't know who that's for or what it is, but some message, some news coming your way very soon, which will be a bit shocking. Guidance for Kylie Emma 1990. Guidance, guidance, guidance. So I think it's a spirit guide message. So I'm going to switch to this deck for Kylie Emma 1990. What is the message for Kylie? What is the message for Kylie? Kylie Emma 1990. Lightning bolt is very natural. Oh, Kylie Emma, this says journey within. So it's talking about going inside yourself. It means if you've got a question, if there's some questions on your mind, that you actually have the answers. It's telling you to spend time with yourself. What I would see this as is, I guess, turn off the radio, turn off the TV, spend a little bit of time with yourself. Whether you do that by maybe having a long warm shower or a bath or something, and just think about your own thoughts. I'm kind of seeing that you might be, you might be getting messages and having thoughts and you're pushing them away, you're ignoring them, and you might be doing that by distracting yourself with stuff, with activities, with busyness, busy work, and music, sound, or TV, other sort of distractions like that. So the message that I've got for you is to journey within yourself by just listening to yourself for a little while. Now, I hate to say the word meditation because I know most people go, ah, meditation, I hate it, I can't do it, I can't do it. But all it is just closing your eyes and taking a few deep breaths. That's all you have to do. When something comes to you, listen to that and pay attention to that. That intuition and that gut feeling you've got, those thoughts that you have, you need to hear those, you need to listen to those. I think they'll be positive. I don't think you've got anything there to worry about, but that's what I'm hearing for you. Nurse Matthew wants a purple hoodie. Well, what are you going to do with that request, Nurse Matthew? Do you remember what my previous advice to you was? Can you type it in? Do you remember what my previous advice to you was? That's funny. Just popped up is live your bliss. Oh, you're welcome, Kylie Emma. Live your bliss, really. Follow your dreams. Go for what you want. Get what you want. Get what you want. Manifest the life of your dreams. Manifest abundance. And how are you going to do that, Nurse Matthew? What's the first step you have to take? Have you forgotten already? Buy it yourself. Yes, well, that's one good thing. So around your intentions. Hello, Sid981. Around your intentions, you have to set your intentions and you have to tell the universe what you want. And whether you do that in your own head is fine. Best way to do it is say it out loud. So all those hundreds of thousands of millions of people who manifest a purple hoodie, that's exactly right, Aggie. That's what he has to do. Hundreds of thousands of people or millions of people across the world who pray, it's the same thing. I'm not telling you to get down on your knees and say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. You can if you want, but setting your intentions by saying things out loud and say the same things every day until you get it. Sid981, you would like a reading? Sure. I'm switching decks. I'm going over to this one for you. Let's see what happens here. Sid981 would like a message, please. What's your message for Sid981? What's your message? Do I have a card for Sid, please? Can I have a card for Sid? Hello, Lagaelvm. I'm not really sure how to say that. I gave it a crack. But hello. Okay, Sid, I can feel it coming. I can feel it coming, coming. What's the card for Sid, please? Card for Sid, please. Okay, am I cracking the deck? Yes, I'm... Oops, there we go. Oh, the architect. So it's showing me... Hang on, I'll show you the card. It's showing me that you're building something. You're building, and it doesn't necessarily have to be building something on a physical level. You're creating something. You're making something happen. And you're doing a good job. You're checking in every now and again. It's going well. What you're creating, what you're building, what you're making is going well. Yeah, you need to just, you need to keep an eye on things. And it's also sort of looking to me like you need to get another person's perspective on something. So ask for some, oh, thank you for the roses. It's telling me to that you need to ask for some help or advice or support from somebody who's an expert or knows what it is that you're trying to create. And I don't, again, I don't mean create something as in build something physical. It doesn't have to be building something physical. You could be trying to create a family or trying to create a new career or trying to create love or something like that. That's what I'm seeing for you. Oh, thanks for the roses, guys. Oh, thanks for the likes. Ha ha, you got a Lagaya. Lagaya, Lagaya. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Going through a breakup. So I hope that made sense to you, Sid. Yeah, I hope that you are able to put that in context because I don't know what it means for you in your life. But yeah, the message I'm getting for you is just get some advice from somebody who's an expert on whatever it is that you're trying to create or build in your life. Now, Lagaya, let me have a look and see what I can find for you. Sid, that was around love and finances, abundance. Yeah, I'm thinking that you're on the right track. I'm thinking whatever it is that you're building and you're trying to create is going to come for you, but you need to check in. There'll be check-in points and you need to check in with someone just to get some advice on that. Yeah. Okay, so Lagaya, let's have a look and see what we can see. Message for Lagaya. Laguya? I'm sorry if I'm saying it wrong. Okay, you're going through a breakup. Okay, let's have a look. No, I'm not on the right deck for you. I'm swapping. This is a message directly from your spirit guide. No, that's not it. I'm just waiting for the right one to jump out. It's going to be directly from your guide, who is talking to my guide right now. That's kind of how this works, I think. Yeah, they just, you know, they sort of get together and do lunch or something. Oh, thank you for forgiving me about your name. Let's have a look here. Where's the message for the guy? What card have we got? Oh, I get it. Why you put the U in there? It's for guy, right? Lagaya. Yeah. Ah, oh, this is what you got. Possess self-confidence. Your guides want you to love you. Your guides want you to focus on you. Be confident. Don't be a doormat. Don't let anybody walk over you. Your needs are your needs. Your needs must be met. Your needs will be met if you have the self-confidence. If there's something there where you feel, how are you feeling? There's some sort of anxiety. Oh, no, it's not anxiety. There's some sort of guilt or, oh, dare I say, shame or something like that. There's a very negative feeling that you've got somewhere inside you. It's, you need to get rid of it. Your guides are telling you to possess self-confidence. Be confident in yourself. Let me think about what else is coming through there for you, Lagaya. Yeah, I'm just getting that you, whatever you've learned from this previous situation, you might be taking the wrong lessons from it. The lessons that you need to be taking from it are around your own strength and confidence, around round your wonderfulness. I'm feeling like you're sort of taking a karmic lesson away that's negative, but your guides are kind of slapping you and saying, come on, get with it, girl. Be confident. You are wonderful. You are amazing. Yeah. They love you, your guides. Yeah. Yeah, they're very strong too, very strong. Yeah, that's really nice. That's really positive what I'm getting. It's very strong and very positive. And it's about just wipe it. Anything that's negative that you're feeling, that you're taking on, don't take it on. Wipe it. Get rid of it. Start it. I'm seeing a picture of I don't know how old you are, but in my day there were blackboards before whiteboards. I'm seeing a picture of a blackboard and wiping it. Just wipe it, wipe it, wipe it. Get rid of it. Go. Yeah. Just take confidence. Take confidence. Be confident. Be, if only you could see what they see. That's really nice. Thank you for that question because, yeah, I've enjoyed feeling that energy from them. Very strong, very positive, and very, yeah, literally like slapping you. Hello, Michelle Bigby. Will your life get easier? Struggling and in need of a change. I'm going to my pendulum for you, Michelle, because that's a pretty simple yes or no. I'm glad, Lagaya, that you understand that. Yeah. they've actually been trying to tell you that themselves. I don't know if that makes sense to you, that you've maybe been getting messages that you've ignored or that you haven't been paying attention to or that you've just put down to a coincidence or whatever, but yeah. Yeah, they are. Okay, Michelle, I'm just gonna log in to you. Michelle Bigby. So it's a difficult question. Will my life get easier? I'm getting yes, it's a positive. Your life will get easier if you make it easier. So there are some actions that you need to take and some things that you need to do. And I think you might need to do those things inside, internally. Let me get a card and we'll see what that means. So it's a yes. It's definitely a yes. You're welcome, Lagaya. Okay, Michelle, I'm looking for a card for you to find out what it is that you need to do in the way of making changes. Okay, this is it says give without expectation. Now, so I don't know if that means, let me have a think about that. Let me see what, I'll have a feel about that and download what that means. Give without expectation. It's something about, there's something about a give and take relationship there that's not working. Something where I can tell that your needs are not getting met, but I think it might be a blame situation. There might be somehow that you're putting blame on something that you're not getting this because someone did something wrong or your life's hard because the situation that you're in. So I think what they're telling me or what they're telling you is to give, give, give. And then once you put yourself in that frame of mind of giving, 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 no matter what, then you will get. Does that make sense to you? I hope I'm interpreting that correctly. Give without expectation. Give without expectation. Give without expectation. So it's kind of like, it's a bit about conditionality. Something that it's feeling conditional that you'll do this if that happens, or if that happens, you'll be happy. Ah, yeah, that's a good one. If this happens, you'll be happy. It's a bit like the other man's grass is always greener. The message is definitely give first, give, 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 and then that will set you up to be in a place where you'll get. I hope that helps. I hope that makes sense to you. Oh, thanks for those presents, people. brother pass. So there's a lot of blame. Giving, and not, yeah, okay. So having said that then, Michelle, is there something that you can think of, some sort of energetic pattern that you can change that would create a more giving situation for you? If there's something that you can give without any expectations of anybody giving it back to you, then maybe that will flip that karma for you. It will flip that energy. Yeah, I'm gonna do another card for you. I need a bit more than that because it's not all that clear to me. It might be clear to you. I hope it is. But to me, it's not. And I don't feel like I'm interpreting it very well. So I'm just going to have another crack at it with a different deck of cards here. Thanks for that question, Vintage Nurse Matthew. I'll come back to you. Just wanted to finish this one off for Michelle. Yeah, same again. Geez, I hardly ever get that, the same cards. There's 78 of these, so there's no reason why I should get the same one unless it's the same message. It means you're in a karmic trench. It means you have to do something different to get out of this karmic trench, or you're just going to stay in the same pattern, the same energetic pattern. And it's actually dug. Like, all the trenches are dug. They're there. They're ready. You can hop out. All you just need to do is hop out. So it literally means change something. And it could be changing something that's completely random. It could be, you know, I'm going and buying a new set of clothes. I don't know. It could be changing your diet. It could be changing something small in your life, changing who you hang around with, changing what channel you watch on TV. I don't know. But it's about changing something to create a new energy pattern for you. And I think that will give you some positive energy. Matthew, the question about life getting easier, what do you need to do? Let me have a look at my other deck of cards for you. Hi, Cat PNG1. Yes, I certainly will. I will just finish off this question. Matthew, Vintage Nurse. Don't relinquish your power. Okay. So this, it's talking about being the boss of you. Don't, I'm not saying don't take advice from other people, but, you know, be in charge. Be the authority in your life. Make your own decisions, okay? Don't kowtow to other people. Don't relinquish your power. That's a good message for you, I think. Cat, let's have a look what we've got for you. I'm just going to have some... dropped my phone. I'm just going to have some water, guys. So I've got a couple of messages there queued up. Just don't let me forget them, okay? Remind me if I forget. I'm just going to have a drink. Sorry. Just I find if I'm not hydrated enough, I can't connect. Like, it's sort of, I can feel it just waning away. I know that means I don't have enough water in me. I'll finish that shortly. And I dropped my mouse too. La 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 la. Ooh, there we go. Right. Okay, Cat. Cat, let's have a look what we've got for you. Cat PNG1 wants a love reading, please. Diversity. So, this means... different. Do something different. It means look around in different places. Diversity could almost mean for you that you're looking for love in all the wrong places and you have to try different places around love. It could mean that the person that you are going to fall in love with, or the next love of your life, is actually someone completely different to what you would think. It might be a different skin colour, could be a different gender, could be a different age, I don't know, but it's different, completely different to what you think it's going to be. I don't think that's all that helpful, is it? It probably just means, though, something. Sorry, I just dropped the thing. Wait a minute, I've got myself all confused here. Let's fix all that up. Okay. Music in the background. Yeah, so Cat PNG, your love rating around diversity, something different, doing something different, looking somewhere different, changing things up, I guess. Michelle, have driver's text next week. Held it for the last 7 years. Yes. Yes. That's going to change everything. So, Michelle, that will really give you a whole different pattern of energies that you can work with in your life. Yes, things will change for you, definitely, 100%. Good on you. Emerald, don't really have a question, but is there anything jumping out? So this is Emerald Brunt. Let me have a look. I'm going to ask for a message from your spirit guide team, Emerald. Emerald Brunt, do we have a card for Emerald, please? Any messages for Emerald? Message for Emerald. Oh, there it goes. Okay. It says death is an illusion. So what it's telling me is just to reinforce with you that you are an immortal soul. This is just a body here, this meat sack. This is just an incarnation and an embodiment. And Emerald, I think you have had, I don't even want to put a number on it, many, many past lives, like a lot of lives, past or concurrent or similar lives, different dimensions. I think you might have had a dream recently about something like that. I think that you've been traveling in your sleep state. So something's happened in your sleep state that is related to either past lives or concurrent lives. You might be living another life in another dimension right now at the same time. That's what I'm getting for you. Cat PNG, you're welcome. Michelle Bigby. Change is needed. Yes, I think that too. Emerald, take care of yourself. Absolutely. Matthew, you're welcome. You need a cat to get your mouse. Chloe Louise, 1383. Chloe, let's have a look what we've got for you. Chloe, can I have a card for Chloe, please? We'll see what's going on. This is telling you to be of service. So you have something to offer the world, and whatever it is that you have to offer the world, put it out there. I don't know what it is, but it's something that your guides want you to do, some sort of skill that you have that could be shared with lots of other people. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's creating on TikTok. I don't know. But I'm hoping that makes sense to you, and I'm hoping that it's something that resonates with you, that your spirit guides are kind of saying that they've been trying to give you this message to be of service, serve someone, do something. It might be around, I mean, if we take that literally, it could be volunteering, but I don't think it is. I really think it's more like putting yourself out there and offering yourself to others. Oh, my screen is blurry. Oh, crap. What happened? Wait a minute. Hey, can you guys see me good now? I'm just going back to Cat PNG in a really tough spot. I'm hoping you guys can see me. Wait a minute. I'll go back down to the bottom. Thanks, Chloe. You're welcome. Sav's World. Yes, I will do you. And Emerald, you're welcome.
Carol, yes. Emerald, that's what you feel like. Tough spot with someone. You don't know whether to stay. I'm going to ask for a yes or no question for that one, Cat PNG, okay? Is it within Cat PNG's best interest and highest purpose to stay in the relationship? That's looking like a no to me. Now, I have nothing invested in this. I don't know you, so I'm not trying to, you know. I'm just telling you as I see it. To me, that's a no. Okay. Okay, so Caroline, yes, you can have a reading. I'm doing spirit guide message cards for you. Let's have a look what comes up. Know your truth. Okay, so for Carol Eind, know your truth, meaning stick with your beliefs and your gut feeling. I feel like maybe someone's trying to convince you of something or someone's trying to change your... It's telling you to stick with your gut. I hope that makes sense to you. I hope that you had a question around that because, yeah, it's just saying just stick with, go with your own intuition, know your truth, believe what you have to say. And I'm not saying, you know, fuck other people, but you don't necessarily have to be swayed by other people's opinions. Hold tight, guys. I just need to get my charger because otherwise the phone's going to go flat and I'm not wanting to finish yet. I'm still feeling like there's more messages that somebody needs. So I'm just plugging in. Okay, that worked. Looks like you're all still there. Yeah. Okay, balancing, nice. Now, if I missed anyone, who did I miss? Carol's done. Sav's World. Okay, Sav's World. I'm doing Akashic Tarot cards for you. And let's have a look what comes up. Chloe Louise, you're welcome. Still blurry a little. I don't know how or why. Like, what could I have pressed? Could I have pressed something? Could I have done something? I don't know what I changed on here. Maybe I need to do different effects or something. Hang on. Maybe I need to press enhance. Tell me if this makes a difference. Smooth eyes, face. I don't know if that makes any difference. Yes, hello, 3 Haley. Just doing Sav's World now. Sorry if it's blurry, guys. I don't really know what to do to change that. Okay, message for Sav's World. Is anybody else seeing it blurry looking? Thanks for the roses. That's your card there, Sav. Oh, it is, yes. So this card is Caught in the Ruins. I'll just show you the picture. I'm getting a lot of major arcana. So Caught in the Ruins, these two are sitting there in what they think is jail. They're sitting in a prison cell. So they feel stuck. But what they don't realise is that the door's not locked. So all they have to do is walk out. And that's the same for you. If you feel like you're trapped in some circumstances, if there's something that's making you feel trapped, I can't think of another better way to say it, just walk out, leave it behind. You don't need it. I hope that makes some sense to you. Oh, it looks good on your end. Thanks, Bree, for letting me know. Yep, and Vintage Nurse Matthew's saying it's clear as well. So, Caroline, I don't know if it's blurry for you. Maybe it's your phone or something. I'm not sure. Okay, 3 Haley. Let's have a look what we've got for you. Let's have a look here.
Clear as the sky. Is the sky clear? I don't know. That looks like that's your card. The scribe. So this is telling me there's learning coming up. Learning information, literature. I think it actually is probably telling you, I'm not blurry, thanks Sev's World. It's telling you, it's another major arcana once again. Yeah, good idea, Carol. It's telling me you need to enroll in something, or that there's something there that you need to learn. Or if you're studying already, that you've got an exam coming up. Yeah, so this is definitely about information coming your way, definitely about learning and taking on something to do with education or training. And it's a positive thing. I feel good about it. Yeah, it feels good. Can somebody get rid of that Aussie man, please? Block that person. Oh, thank you. The only Nara, absolutely. I support everybody except that Aussie man because he just insulted me for no reason. Like, why say things about my hair? My hair is my choice. Like, see, you don't have a profile picture on there. Can someone, one of my moderators, block him or delete him, please? Horrible person. Oh, thanks, Brie. Yeah, so yes, the only Nara, I support everybody who's, yeah, everybody who wants my support, absolutely, 100%. Do you have a question for me? Do you have something that you're wanting me to... The only Nara, do you have a question for me? It keeps coming up saying... Yeah, I guess my theory is this is the way I see things now. I've changed a lot of my perspective since I've been... Hello, karma, better than you, boy. Okay. Yeah, since I've been involved in this spiritual world and my journey and learning, I've realized or evidenced that we are all connected, all of us, every single one of us. So if I do something to hurt you, in the end, I'm hurting me, because what hurts you hurts me. So whilst I don't choose to hurt anyone, the thing about it is I just don't understand why people do things to hurt people. I could not for the life of me understand why anyone would go onto TikTok, see somebody on live, and just make nasty comments towards them. What do they get out of it? Now, whilst I don't want to hurt that person, because I know in the end that will hurt me as well, and I don't want to be, you know, I don't want to get revenge or anything like that, I really just don't get it. I don't understand. If anyone can explain to me, well, feel free to try, but I still don't think I will get it. So anyway, your message. Your message. How did you go with that, Bree Jackson, my fabulous moderator? Did you figure it out? Because when you figured it out, you can teach me, right? Oh, I see it. There it is. Aussieman.16 was blocked. Thank you. I'll tip you later. So the only Nara, I think... I'm going to pull a card for that. Oh, I think the only Nara might be gone, is she? She, he? Deanne Hunter, Bree Jackson, Thorne, User Rex Scooby, Indigenous Matthew. So, karma better than new boy. Interesting usernames here, aren't they? People are so creative. I'm just going to pull a general card. And I think I might make this a couple of second lasty cards. Oh, because it's 8:30 already. It's nearly my bedtime. I have to go and meditate. I'm going a bit nuts if I'm not meditating by about 9 o'clock every night. There we go. There's our card. Oh, two worlds. That's exactly what I was just talking about. Two worlds, being stuck between two worlds. We've got this internal world going on, I have, which is, you know, the stuff that I'm kind of learning and listening to and channeling from spirit. And then there's the other world, the outside of the body world, where it's the physical world here on earth, and you have to do things and you have to go through the motions and you have to pay the bills and you have to follow the laws and do all that sort of stuff. So really, really being stuck in this juncture between two worlds. That's where I feel I am at this time of night, because I'm in this world on earth doing the things that I need to do and I'm drawn to do and pulled to do. But I'm just waiting and waiting and waiting until I can lay my head down and start meditating and get back into my other world, which is my spirit world. Okay, one new message. What else is going on here? As it pops up telling me I've got new messages and then they just kind of disappear. So I don't really understand what that is. Yeah. All right, so any of you guys who are still on there, feel free to ask any more questions. I think I've probably got about half an hour left in me before I have to crash and get back into my other world. User X Scooby Bones. Thorn? I don't think I know you either. I'm happy to do questions for you if you want something. If there's anything you've got, any questions you've got. Javier Innit. I'm more smart than you. Well, that makes no sense. Did you mean to say than me? Clearly, problem there. Okay, I've blocked that person. Ah, good one. Thanks, Bri. I'm more smart than you. Hilarious. Oh, they can't help it. I shouldn't pick on people. All right. Last couple of messages, I suppose. I think I've answered everybody's questions already. Let's have a look and see if we've got any generalness. Generalness coming. Generalness for those who are watching. Three left on there. Everybody else has gone to bed, I'd say. Whoa. The treasure. We had that one before already as well. So for those of you who are wanting something, looking for something, feeling like you can't find it, it's disappointing, you're devastated, all your treasure's gone missing, just turn around because it's right behind you in the treasure box. It's right behind you. You're just looking in the wrong place. Yes, TGV Tribe. This is my Woody. Yes, it's comfy. I got the koala one.